7. This is the continuation part of the previous video. In the previous video, I started with the chapter number 8 from your English Rapid, and the name of the chapter was Will He Stay? We have completed up to the page number 33. So please take out your book and turn to page number 34. From page number 34, we are going to start. So we have learned that Mr. Farfrae was went to the downstairs, and he was singing the songs. He was singing the patriotic songs, and everyone, that means all of the people, were enjoying those songs because he was a very good singer, and he was singing those songs with a lot of emotions. So not only Mr. Farfrae, but also all the peoples of, not all, all the peoples, that means the peoples who were around Mr. Farfrae, all of them were, recalling their past. They were recalling their motherland. And now some people, they were requesting Mr. Farfrae to sing another song. But Mr. Farfrae told that he had only that much of list. Now we are going to start from the page number 34. He sang O Nainy beautifully and ended with Auld Lang Syne. So what is that? Mr. Farfrae was singing some beautiful songs, and he started with a very famous song, and also he ended with a very famous song too. Even the landlord and Mrs. Stannage watched from door. So all of the people were enchanted by the beautiful singing of Mr. Farfrae. Here the landlord and his wife were also, they were also enchanted by the singing style of Mr. Farfrae. The guests were fascinated about the distant land he came from, and were surprised when he told them that it was not snowbound all year as they thought, but only in winter. So all of the people were they wanted to know that from where this man had come. So they were, Mr. Farfrae was saying that he was coming from north, that means the Scotland. And all of them, they had the idea that if this man was coming from Scotland, that means throughout the year the Scotland is having the snow. But Farfrae told that no, it's only at the time of winter they get the snow, but not throughout the year. Nor were the dangerous animals as they fear. Not only that, this snow, but also the people of Casterbridge, they had the idea that Scotland is having the dangerous type of animals. And this man, Mr. Farfrae, was telling them that no, there were no dangers in Scotland of these animals. Okay. Farfrae said he had sent his baggage ahead of him. Elizabeth Jane was taken up by the man. She found he gave serious thought to many matters. What happened? So Mr. Farfrae told that he was leaving the hotel, and Elizabeth Jane had, she felt that she was interested in this man somehow. She found he gave serious thought to many matters. Farfrae said he would go up to rest. Although it was not very late, the landlady asked Elizabeth to go his bed ready. Elizabeth actually wanted to know about many matters of this man, because Elizabeth could understand by her thought, it was Elizabeth's thought, she was feeling that this man is full of mystery, and that is why Elizabeth wanted to know more and more about the man. And what happened? Farfrae said that it was very late, so he would go. Farfrae told that it was not late, sorry. He told that he would go because he needed the rest, though it was not very late. So landlady informed Elizabeth to go over there and make the bed ready for Mr. Farfrae. Elizabeth Jane took a candle and went up. Elizabeth Jane took a candle and went up. That means she took one candle. Okay. As she was coming down, having made the bed, she met Farfrae. She looked down at the candle as they crossed. So when Elizabeth made ready for the bed for Mr. Farfrae, and then she came back, and when she was crossing, she saw that Mr. Farfrae was over there, and she did not look at Mr. Farfrae, only they crossed the path. He smiled and sang a few lines. Elizabeth Jane went to her room soon after. Elizabeth Jane did not look at the man, but the man, maybe he got one, he was looking at Elizabeth Jane, and then the man smiled and she was singing a few lines. Elizabeth Jane then went to her room after that incident. Her mother said that it had been a mistake to serve in the inn because it may bring bad repute to him. Suzanne meant Mr. Henchard, but Elizabeth Jane thought she referred to Mr. Farfrae. Suzanne actually told her daughter that as Elizabeth was serving the inn, so Suzanne was telling that it may have the bad effect, bad reputation for Mr. Henchard. But Elizabeth thought that her mother was telling it maybe have a bad effect on Mr. Farfrae. Okay. Henchard, after walking out of the inn, walked up and down High Street, going past the inn several times. So Mr. Henchard, you know that he left the inn, but he could not able to leave the place around the inn. He was several times he went that means he was walking in the street, and but he could not able to leave the place. He heard the Scotsman sing and stopped to listen. When Mr. Farfrae was singing the song, so at that time he was listening the song very minutely, and he could not able to leave the place. He confessed to himself that the young man had caught his fancy, and he would readily give him a third of his business if he had stayed. So Mr. Henchard liked this man very much. He was fascinated by the good qualities of Mr. Farfrae, and so Mr. Henchard decided that if this man would stay here with Mr. Henchard, so Mr. Henchard would give him one third of his business property to this man. He was Mr. Henchard was very much he liked the man very much. Okay.